Hello everyone, welcome to the English Devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Father, I thank you and I praise you for another day of life, another opportunity to serve you. I thank you and I praise you, Lord, because of your faithfulness and your mercy that's new every morning. Father, I ask that you will forgive me of my sins and the offenses I've done against you so that my prayer can enter your holy throne. Thank you, Father, for all that you have done for us. Thank you, Father God, for the work that we have been able to do in your name, for providing us the resources, the health, and the willingness to do your work. Father, I ask that you will be with those who are struggling in their faith today. Father, be with those who are tempted to walk away and throw in the towel and give up. Father, I ask that you will make yourself very known to them, that you will visit them in a very special way to encourage them to keep on going. Father, I ask that you will comfort those who need comforting, that you will strengthen those who are feeling weak today. Father, be with the parents and guide them in training their children in your path. Be with the children, Lord, who are facing temptations of several kinds that we don't even understand anymore. Be with them and help them to make the right decision that will bring honor and glory to you. These things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Let's Make a Difference. It was written by Morama Gonzalez and translated by Stacy Martinez. Our biblical base can be found in Romans chapter 12, verse 21. So says the word of God. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. Let's make a difference so that Christ may be seen. The worlds will then believe what we preach is true and not just pretense. Let's make the presence of God noticeable so people may be drawn to our Christian community and know that there is a name by which they can be saved. Let's make a difference so that our light may shine through and good may conquer evil. Let us never forget what it means to be Christian. When you fill your hands with what the world lacks and Jesus freely offers, know you are truly blessed, my brother. Let's be the difference between a world that seeks only to cause pain and one sensitive to those who are hurting. Let's keep a good appearance, but more importantly, a pure heart. That way, from both inside and out, we will reflect the image of Christ. Let's make a difference so that Christ may be seen and the world may believe. Let it be our heart and not mere appearances that impact them. Let them clearly see the difference in us before Christ and after Christ, and may what they see lead them to seek salvation themselves. We are a different people called to make a difference. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we are the light of the world. Our testimony, our lives are standing on a hilltop as a lamp that others see. We cannot be hidden. Our example, our testimony is going to shine. My brothers and sisters, I invite you to consciously make the effort to be the difference that people can see Christ through you. For those who have come to Christ at a later age, maybe recently, and people know us from before, they know what we were like, and they see us now. My brothers and sisters, that is the difference that people are looking at. When we respond in a sensitive way to those who are hurting, we are being the difference. When we have our light shine through and we do good in the midst of evil, that is the difference. When we reach out with a compassionate hand full of empathy to check on our brothers and sisters, our co-workers, our neighbors, our friends, and we ask them, how are you? How can I pray for you today? I care about you. Jesus loves you. That is being the difference. My brothers and sisters, today you are being called to be the difference. Be the light that shines Christ so clearly. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn, and hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle and go light your way. Some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. 'Cause we are a family whose hearts are blazing, so let's raise our candles and light up the sky, praying to our Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkest times.
Amen, what a beautiful song. Now we invite you to continue listening to our daily Bible reading, which can be found in Romans chapter 13, 14, and 15. So says the Word of God.
Romans chapter 13. Let every soul be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and the authorities that exist are appointed by God. Therefore, whoever resists the authority resists the ordinance of God, and those who resist will bring judgment on themselves. For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to evil. Do you want to be unafraid of the authority? Do what is good, and you will have praise from the same. For he is God's minister to you for good. But if you do evil, be afraid, for he does not bear the sword in vain. For he is God's minister, an avenger to execute wrath on him who practices evil. Therefore, you must be subject, not only because of wrath, but also for conscience' sake. For because of this, you also pay taxes, for they are God's ministers, attending continually to this very thing. Render therefore to all their due, taxes to whom taxes are due, customs to whom customs, fear to whom fear, honor to whom honor. Owe no one anything except to love one another, for he who loves another has fulfilled the law. For the commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not covet, and, if there is any other commandment, all are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no harm to a neighbor, therefore love is the fulfillment of the law. And do this, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep, for now our salvation is nearer than when we first believed. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Therefore let us cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the day, not in revelry and drunkenness, not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lusts. Romans chapter 14. Receive one who is weak in the faith, but not to disputes over doubtful things. For one believes he may eat all things, but he who is weak eats only vegetables. Let not him who eats despise him who does not eat, and let not him who does not eat judge him who eats, for God has received him. Who are you to judge another's servant? To his own master he stands or falls. Indeed, he will be made to stand, for God is able to make him stand. One person esteems one day above another, another esteems every day alike. Let each be fully convinced in his own mind. He who observes the day observes it to the Lord, and he who does not observe the day, to the Lord he does not observe it. He who eats, eats to the Lord, for he gives God thanks, and he who does not eat, to the Lord he does not eat, and gives God thanks. For none of us lives to himself, and no one dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and rose and lived again, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. But why do you judge your brother, or why do you show contempt for your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ, for it is written, As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. So then each of us shall give account of himself to God. Therefore, let us not judge one another any more, but rather resolve this, not to put a stumbling block or a cause to fall in our brother's way. I know and am convinced by the Lord Jesus that there is nothing unclean of itself, but to him who considers anything to be unclean, to him it is unclean. Yet if your brother is grieved because of your food, you are no longer walking in love. Do not destroy with your food the one for whom Christ died. Therefore, do not let your good be spoken of as evil. For the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. For he who serves Christ in these things is acceptable to God and approved by men. Therefore, let us pursue the things which make for peace and the things by which one may edify another. Do not destroy the work of God for the sake of food. All things indeed are pure, but it is evil for the man who eats with offense. It is good neither to eat meat, nor drink wine, nor do anything by which your brother stumbles, or is offended, or is made weak. Do you have faith? Have it to yourself before God. Happy is he who does not condemn himself in what he approves. But he who doubts is condemned if he eats, because he does not eat from faith. for whatever is not from faith is sin. Romans chapter 15. We then who are strong ought to bear with the scruples of the weak, and not to please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, leading to edification. For even Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproached you fell on me. For whatever things were written before were written for our learning, that we, through the patience and comfort of the Scriptures, might have hope. Now may the God of patience and comfort grant you to be like-minded toward one another according to Christ Jesus, that you may with one mind and one mouth glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, receive one another, just as Christ also received us, to the glory of God. Now I say that Jesus Christ has become a servant to the circumcision for the truth of God, to confirm the promises made to the fathers, and that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy, as it is written, "For this reason I will confess to you among the Gentiles, and sing to your name." And again he says, "Rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people." And again, "Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Laud him, all you peoples." And again Isaiah says, "There shall be a root of Jesse, and he who shall rise to reign over the Gentiles, in him the Gentile shall hope." Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now I myself am confident concerning you, my brethren, that you also are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, able also to admonish one another. Nevertheless, brethren, I have written more boldly to you on some points, as reminding you, because of the grace given to me by God, that I might be a minister of Jesus Christ to the Gentiles, ministering the gospel of God, that the offering of the Gentiles might be acceptable, sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, I have reason to glory in Christ Jesus in the things which pertain to God. For I will not dare to speak of any of those things which Christ has not accomplished, through me, in word and deed, to make the Gentiles obedient, in mighty signs and wonders, by the power of the Spirit of God, so that from Jerusalem and round about to Illyricum I have fully preached the gospel of Christ. And so I have made it my aim to preach the gospel, not where Christ was named, lest I should build on another man's foundation, but, as it is written, to whom he was not announced, they shall see, and those who have not heard shall understand. For this reason I also have been much hindered from coming to you. But now, no longer having a place in these parts, and having a great desire these many years to come to you, whenever I journey to Spain I shall come to you, for I hope to see you on my journey, and to be helped on my way there by you, if first I may enjoy your company for a while. But now I am going to Jerusalem to minister to the saints, for it pleased those from Macedonia and Achaia to make a certain contribution for the poor among the saints who are in Jerusalem. It pleased them indeed, and they are their debtors. For if the Gentiles have been partakers of their spiritual things, their duty is also to minister to them in material things. Therefore, when I have performed this and have sealed to them this fruit, I shall go by way of you to Spain. But I know that when I come to you, I shall come in the fullness of the blessing of the gospel of Christ. Now I beg you, brethren, through the Lord Jesus Christ, and through the love of the Spirit, that you strive together with me in prayers to God for me, that I may be delivered from those in Judea who do not believe, and that my service for Jerusalem may be acceptable to the saints, that I may come to you with joy by the will of God, and may be refreshed together with you. Now the God of peace be with you all. Amen.
Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the Scripture. Thank you so much for tuning in once again to our daily devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. As usual, it is my prayer that this devotional will be a blessing and encouragement to you in your spiritual walk, no matter where you are. If you're just starting out or you've been a career Christian for many, many years walking this path, I pray that this will be a blessing to you so that you can in turn be a blessing and a light and a difference to others around you. And now we ask the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.